Hey guys, Ellison Cruz here. Welcome back to Eternal Sonata. We just actually went through the entirety of Alcoda Ruins, and we talked to this old hag about our fortune. So now we're gonna head off over here to Cowbell Heights, where we want some more. God, okay, sorry, that kind of started getting bad. I'm not gonna make any Christopher Walken references, but yes, we're in Cowbell Heights, and this place serves absolutely zero purpose except just like that prairie, the Great Prairie after the Go-Go Village. Has the same music and kind of is just this long path of just loading the next area, which is a mountain-based area, which isn't too bad, but it feels too similar to that to Wallava Cave, in my opinion. So let's go talk to this fatty over here.
Hey, if it isn't Chaz! Chaz, it is you!
That's my name, all right. Well, of all things, I didn't think you were still alive. Wow, that is a really nice thing to say to somebody. I didn't think you were still alive. I'm sure you'd been done in during the rebellion. Nope, Jazz took care of all of them to survive it.
This is kind of a one-sided conversation, but no claves.
The mountain. The situation on the Forte side has gotten much worse since... Oh. Increased surveillance and the work... Surveillance? What kind of surveillance? With, like, your three security guards? God. Told you some of the miners are still very angry with Tenor. I wonder who this Tenor fellow is. What is that flower thing in the back? Jeez, by the way, what did you come back here for? It's like, oh, finally giving me a chance to spot to talk. I was going to say speak, but no, one second. Okay, so he's just going to keep talking to himself and just be like, duh, okay. Okay, so now that that is done, go ahead and equip some stuff. Now, this guy has some pretty good equips, and we're amazing on money right now. So we're going to go buy some stuff. Now, we got a Blossom Parasol for Polka, Magnum Arm for Beat, Mistletine, whatever, for Frederick, New Weapon, Artemis's Bow, Municipal Pime, I'm not even going to bother, Soul Cremator, Zhao Shu, and then we got some armor. Now, this gives us Darkness Body, and... I don't know if you want it. We're going to get a new armor just like this. That's going to be better, so you might want to equip at least one of these. But I think I might equip this on Jazz, simply because we have Whirlwind for his secondary light attack, so whatever. We got Gorgeous Clothes. We're going to want to buy one for Beat, obviously, because it makes his stats so much more fabulous. But now we're just going to buy two for Salsa and Polka. We're going to buy Fog Cloak for Frederick. We're going to buy Obscure Jackets, two of those. And that is all we've got. Now let's go Equipomania. We're going to have Zhao Chu and then blah, 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 Obscure Jacket. And then I already did that. And then we actually... Wait, Doomguard. Wait a second. Okay. And then we're going to find a weapon later for Allegretta. That kind of sucks-ish, but not really. It's just worse than the one we have right now, so it's no real need. And then Matchlock Axe, even though we haven't even used it, like half of these things, just like always. We barely use their new weapons. I should probably be selling all this stuff, even though I don't need the money. It just makes menu navigation a bit more better, I guess. So, oh, nothing for her. She sucks. Just kidding. Marsha's pretty cool. She's a hipster. And then we got Gorgeous Clothes for Salsa. So yeah, why can't Salsa and... March intertwined weapons or anything. God, it don't make a lick of sense to me. Allegretta might need some healing pretty soon, so might as well get that out of the way with the floral powder. So we have a ton of those. Alright, now let's get started on this area. This area is actually pretty easy, so don't worry. And the enemies here serve to kind of a throwback to earlier chapters of the game. You'll see what I mean in a second, but it's not too bad, so let's just get started. And my mic was, like, drooping. So you see these guys, after not having seen them since the Forest Haven or whatever in Chapter 1, I do believe. It's been a long time since we've seen these guys, and now they're a lot more powerful. So, in the dark, they give us a lot more experience, but in the dark, they don't barely even change. They just get a simple color palette swap. So, I guess we'll fight some of those guys later. And then we got these chew jelly things again. I don't even know why I said that like that, but whatever. Let's continue onwards, because these guys suck and we don't have to fight them, really. Okay, I guess we're going to fight this guy. Don't take all day. And alright, so there's effects from the armor or whatever that we got. And attack. And not death, because these guys are pretty strong, actually. Oh, I actually did kill him. Oh, and I could have guarded. Okay, you know what? Since I'm in the darkness, I should switch spots with Pulsetta. Because she's in the light, and Allegretto's a lot better in the light than dark. So as you can see, those two guys gave us more experience than the guys at Alcota Ruin. So again, I'm eating my words, but whatever. Alright, so let's continue onward. Okay, now we're going to... let's fight another one of these guys. I want to fight them in threes, because they give us a ton of experience. Not like we necessarily need it, but... Oh, come on, game. Gotcha! Except, just kidding. Whatever. And death with Scarlet Flash. Black holes and revelation. Yeah, I'm not going to be referencing English bands of the usish nature. And he's dead. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Die, death, please. Death via amazing killing spree. And we leveled up, and Algaro's going to level up in the next episode. Next episode, next battle, god. So I'm still recording off that last one, as you can tell. I'm kind of still tired, so... Recording is so much fun when you're tired and can't even keep your thoughts on a simple train of thought. Whatever. I don't know. It might be entertaining for some people, but I can see how it can be discombobulating to others. Others are like, oh my god, this guy needs to do whatever. And now we get a little personal-ness. Why is there green light out there? The second we step out there, it's going to be all red and jazz. This is where Tenor and I parted ways. I remember it well. The tide had turned against us and retreat was our only option. I thought we'd be safe. We could just make it to Baroque. I was such a fool. No sooner had we crossed the border than Forte's army came pouring through right after us. We finally made it to this cave. This is the spot where those of us who remained banded together make a final stand. It's like, we can't hear you, Jazz. You're kind of not even looking at us. So, having made up my mind to fight to death, they weren't easy words for me to hear. I felt as if I was being torn apart. Bass. You're kidding me, right? His name is Bass. Bass, Jazz, and Tanner. Okay, you can kind of tell they slightly tried a little too difficult with this game. Of course, this does happen to be all of an interpretation of Chopin's memories or whatever. Game. Alright, so we see these red guys, and these guys are a bit more powerful than those black guys, and that's kind of racist because considering our location. Let's go kill him! Haha! Who are you? Better back off. So, let's kill this jerk. And these guys actually take almost more than two combos to kill. Why is there weird lighting on you there? That's kind of weird. Whatever. Like, even a Jazz 32 Echo Heatblade can't kill these guys in one hit. I was amazed. Except what? What? How does... Okay, as I say that our best attack came and kill him, Allegretto goes down and kicks that guy's ass. Oops. I'm trying to do the A's. It didn't work. I was trying... Every time they're close to death, I'm going to try and counterattack them instead of just guarding. Because I still want to show that off. And it's probably just these red guys that are taking so much... That takes so long to kill, as you can tell. Even right here. Bam! Alright. So those guys give pretty good experience. Wait. No, they don't. I don't know. But anyway, there's level 34. 34. To the flow. Drop down. There's an item over there. I don't know if we're going to grab it. Yeah, let's kill this guy really fast. We want to make this episode worthwhile. Because we're actually really close to the end of this area already, except there's a couple more things that we're going to want to grab that is highly... God damn it. I can't even tell where I'm standing. Okay. Okay. I guess he's just going to keep running into me like an idiot. Oh, damn it. Okay. Yeah, not the smartest enemy, I got to admit, but I don't know. And black holes and revelations in your face. Death. And, okay, it's sometimes weird because you can't really tell if they died or not. So, Geoblade, blah, blah, blah. And come on, come on, come on. Death, alright. And then more death. So, yay, we win. Why am I not surprised? And one more battle on Falsetto Games level. Woo! And for that, we get a treasure chest. which is No Name, which is for March. No Name March. So,
a weapon forgotten by the fates.
Does not exist. 404 could not be found. 404. I said that really weird. So I'm going to try and skip these jerks now. You idiots. Game and get me, you jerks. Now, if you want to skip this entire part, you can. If you just head out to the left side, obviously. So this is just like kind of an optional part, but I'd highly recommend doing it if you're doing one of those more or less trying to get everything. I already screwed that up with Frederick's weapon back in the Uriah Temple. I apologize for that. But it is kind of a pointless weapon. As you can see, we get a ton of weapons really fast. Aloof fiddle. Yes, now we're going to perform a couple of sessions with this jerk. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. All right. Aloof fiddle. It doesn't sound like a fiddle. Sounds like a not fiddle. And rank B, so exciting.
Road of travel shows you many things. You're still young. You come in experience with age and progression. Whatever. We got floral powder.
So you're going to diss on me and then give me something to make me feel better? Very nice. I like your style. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. We're going to play number 11. All right. So 12 and 11. Oh, wait. Did I just count the wrong one? Damn it. That's embarrassing. Okay. Maybe I need to stop being so lazy. I need to count these correctly. Okay, I'm pretty sure it's 11 and 12, not 12 and 13. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, I played number 10. Nice. Game, why do I have to be so impatient? Why do I have to not care on camera? Like, I could not care while I'm not on camera, and then I'd be perfectly okay with it. But then here, I'll be recording, and I'll not press something enough time. Something. God, it's annoying. And then we got Sunlight Guards, which is actually something. It just increases defense by, I think, 10%, which is okay, I guess, but not really that great. Ah, no! Wow, I'm really surprised how well I did that battle. I almost got a counterattack on, but... God, excuse me, falsetto leveled up. So, yeah, those three guys right there give us a ton of experience, almost 200,000 or 20,000 or whatever. I can't even tell. Secondary mine shaft, whatever. I don't care. So we're going to head back this way. And I can't believe I got back attack. That sucks. I hate when you can't tell. So I'm going to try and... oh, crap. No, please, sir. I'm going to try and negotiate with you. Please don't attack me with your big pointy stick. You're a bird that doesn't belong with you. You're like a unicorn thing also. I have no idea what the game developers want when they decided to create you. Okay, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to say that. You guys don't have to keep looking at me like that. Can you please go back to patrolling? I promise I'll leave slowly. I'm leaving. I'm walking away now. Please not. Ah! All right, there we go. Jazz game level. Awesome. Yeah, so we get it, Jazz. You're a guy. You're a man. You have like a trombone for your gun. And we're going past you because you're an asshole. And you guys, I was basically holding up the white flag. White flag, blah, 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 blah. I wish I knew the words to this kind of bad song only because the second half turned into some kind of crappy rap song that wasn't very good. IMO, but whatever. Now let's continue here. And then there's like wind here, so super fast. And we could sneak past you because we're awesome. And let's open this chest, which actually got really fast that time. We got antelope armor, and this is something you can equip instead of having the cursed armor, like I said. So if you had cursed armor, I'd recommend switching it out for this. Our attack would have gone down even if we did have the cursed armor, so don't worry about that. And it only gives us like 3 less defense than the cursed armor, but at least we're not dark, so we can still use our starlight thing. Now we're going to head back over here. Hopefully I don't get attacked. Okay. Yes. Your brother shows mercy. Now guess what? You don't have to go off to the right. Now the right is completely optional. But I'm going to do it just to show it. And look, I'm Michael Jackson. I'm doing the moonwalk right off the side of the cliff. God, every time I think of, like, Michael Jackson sometimes, I think of, I can't be the only person. I really hope I'm not, but I always think of Rush Hour, like the first one where Chris Tucker's like singing in the bar and he's like, he's doing that dance. Don't stop taking. I don't know why I always have to. I don't know. I really like Jackie Chan. He's awesome, but I don't know why I always think of that scene. It's probably because I saw that movie when I was really young and it was just embedded in my head for my entire life, and I don't know. Yeah, my dad let me watch a bunch of like PG-13 rated R movies when I was young. Like every time he'd watch me when my mom was in there, I'd always have like a ton of R movies. God, just like a couple of years ago when my sister was like 4 or 5 years old, he was watching like the fucking Terminator with her. I was like, what the hell is this? Like, who the hell watches the Terminator with a 4 year old? And God, it wasn't the Terminator, it was the Punisher. I don't know why I was thinking the Terminator. But Jane Thomas, God, he's kind of cool. But the second Punisher, I did not understand. Like, I saw some clips from it. It just seemed really dumb. God, like, it didn't seem like the Punisher at all. It just seemed like this gory action flick. And these guys are just going to... There we go. Thank you. Don't have to be jerk-offs. God. All right, so this is basically where we're going to end off the level. That weapon we got is weaker than the one we have now, so I wouldn't recommend equipping it. But, yeah, that's all we're going to do. We're about ready to face the boss, end off the chapter, and, discover some new plot twists. So, hope you guys enjoyed it. In the next one, we're going to go ahead and fight our epic boss right over there. So, I will talk to you guys later.